some citronol here so we can make sure that we don't get scurvy, because you have to worry about scurvy when you're on the high seas. As a pirate, scurvy is the worst. So. Hey everyone, Arahli here, and thank you for joining me today as we play some Ark on the Geeks Patreon server. How you guys doing? You having a good day? I'm having a great day. There's kind of a weird thing built around me. You might notice. It's odd. It's on a raft. It's called Work in Progress. It's a little weird, right? There's just kind of a bunch of stuff hanging out. So, what's going on here is I actually have built a boat. It's taken me a while to figure out a way that I wanted to do something, and I wanted to show you guys, but to make sure it was going to work, I wanted to build it first. So I did that. And right now, it's over there. You can't see it, but it's over there. So I wanted to bring you guys back for kind of the weird parts of this build, because I did some kind of odd things, and it wasn't tremendously easy to make it work. I actually tried recording a video of it already, and it turned out like garbage. It was very hard to show you guys what it was doing and still have a nice flow to the video. So I figured what I'd do instead is I would build half of the boat so I could kind of show you the harder parts of this build and actually walk you through those directly. One second. So I'm going to show you kind of how to do the harder parts of the build, and then I'll actually take you over to the completed one. And then at some point, this will become a second one of these. I just am not going to finish right away. I just wanted to be able to show you guys kind of the basic stuff. So let's jump into it. This is actually part of the advanced raft mod. This is a large raft. You can see a bunch of pieces we're going to need in here to kind of get this working. It doesn't matter if it's a large raft or not. I'm using it because I like the mod. This build, it's only possible with S+, and you have to change some settings to make this work. So in S+, we turned off the need for foundation support. It's the only way to actually make this do what I want it to do without costing tons of material. So we turned it off, honestly, just so I could make this. So I'm going to show you guys kind of how this works. So the first part we're going to talk about is the actual triangle front up here. To get this to work, you would start like you normally would, you just put a thatch piece out and kind of attach on. But when you get to a certain point, you're going to need to actually start doing them off the angles to make this work. So let me go ahead and grab a few of these guys. We'll just take 5. And then what'll happen is you'll kind of have to get into the water here, and you'll see that we need to just go ahead and attach them here. Okay, now I'm a bit of a stickler, and I don't like that they're this direction, so I've been fixing those as I've gone. I'm not going to do this for this one, but I will tell you that, like, on the other one, I made sure that the wood all faced the same direction because I'm weird, and that kind of stuff annoys me. So there's that one there. We're going to put another one right here. Okay. And then we have to actually get one in there, but the problem is you can't do that with where these are at now. So now we have to pick up the thatch ceilings. Oh, and it does that weird thing where it kind of bumps you down every once in a while. And now what we're going to do for those thatch is we're going to actually put it up at an angle. So we're going to attach it to the angled piece like that. So see how it overlaps this triangle at a weird spot, but it's lined up off this wall? That will let us snap this other one in place in the correct direction. Okay, so now we'll have to put another one out here, so we can put that piece in, and you kind of see that's how we're going to continue the shape. Ooh, can we get this? Okay, let's go ahead and pick these up, so you kind of see what I'm talking about. To complete the shape, that's the direction we have to go. So that should be pretty much the end of that, if I remember correctly. I think so. Is that towards the middle? Nope, so we'd have to actually come out a little bit more. So I think I've got enough to kind of show you this. So we'll go ahead and do that. Oh, we need to do 8. Pick this up again. We'll put that off this way. Okay, I need to obviously pick some more stuff up. So we're going to go back to the raft. But you can see the idea is that it's going to eventually come to a point right out here. Now, we'll have to put another piece under here and then one over there. So we'll go ahead and grab those real quick. And then that's actually going to be important a little later on, too, because there's kind of a weird thing to do for me to show you how I ended this front triangle piece here. So go ahead and put this piece in, and then take that again. And then again. So that's now at the center. Okay. So the last part we'd have to do for this is to go ahead and extend it out one more to get it actually right in the center. And that would be the point of the boat. So just pick this up and we'll go back so you can see how that looks. Alright, so obviously we would have this kind of filled in too, but the idea is to get to a single point out here to make this work. Okay, so gotta look out here so you can see we come out to a point, which should be, I might be one off. Did I go one off? Yeah, I think I went one off. that's what happens when you don't have the entire boat that you're working with. So that's, we're going to change this a little bit when we get to the front of the other piece. And I'll actually probably show you this on the other boat because it'll make more sense. You can see how that one's going to end up. And the back part is, this is, I built this boat because of this thing I want to put back here. Okay, so we'll go ahead and get in here. I'm going to take this. Oops, I need this piece. I need this piece. What I wanted to have was essentially a loading dock that we could actually get up in from the water with any dinos, right? So I started with the idea of wanting to have the sloped hatch frame in the back. So I had to kind of modify things a couple times, move things around to get to work, and I found that it would only snap correctly if I put down two foundations. So one of the cool things with S Plus is that you can stack foundations. Just realized I put the one in there that I need. Oh, I do have it. Okay, so you can stack foundations, right? Oh, on top of the piece. So you see how that one's there next to it. We can actually stack down there, or if we can get this lined up, right there, okay? Now, you have to stack those to place this, and then you can go away afterwards. So now at that place, if I press 7, you'll see it's got a whole bunch of weird snap points, but one of them is right there, right? So now we've got a snap point that goes out that direction. We place this in. Get this turned off to manual. Okay, so great, that's there, but now how do you get up from here to here? Well, we'll have to get some ramps in there for it. So we'll go ahead and take these out. And then actually what we should do is go ahead and we put ceilings here. So I need to actually make some ramps because I don't have them. So I'll bring you guys back in just a moment. Okay, we're back. You can see we've got this in. I just want to make sure that I had the ramps we needed. So I'll go ahead and just put these guys right in here. Oh, actually, you know what? Before we do that, let me do one more thing. Because we can make this easier on ourselves in the long run by putting this in. Did I bring the piece with me? I didn't. Of course not. So let's go over here. What we're going to do is actually put some ceilings in place first. If I can access. Can I access the... No? Okay. So all I needed was to get some ceilings out of here. So we want two of these guys. Just put them right there for now. What we're going to do is actually put those down first, right over top of the foundations. And then we're going to go over here, and we'll put these ramps in now. And then this is one of those things I was kind of talking about, though. One of the reasons it's important to do it this way is that with the foundation support turned off, we can just pick these up now. And then we have the nice flat bottom of the boat, but we still have our ramps on the side here. Okay? Now, if you look at this from the outside, let's go ahead and just swim over here real quick. You'll see it kind of looks a little weird. Like, see, it's flat, and I don't like that. So we're going to do something a little weird here to kind of fix that too. So let's go ahead and get over here. This is the reason that we had, this is the other reason we had to turn off the foundation support. So the foundation's gone, but the wall is still there, right? So now what we're going to do, let me get up here. Now what we're going to do is actually place in a sloped wall, because those can actually be turned backwards. Well, that's the wrong one. So let's get the other one. So the cool thing with S Plus is these guys can hang upside down, right? So now we've got an upside down slope piece there, but it still has an opening down there. So now to fix that, we're going to go ahead and put a sloped roof in, and then this should snap to that. It's a little weird. It doesn't always like to snap there. There you go. So now it's snapped in place, okay? And we're going to have to fill in this space here. So that should be, oh, it should be the other one. I guess I'll have to probably place the ceiling in first. Did I bring another ceiling? I did not. Let's grab another ceiling. It's gonna be like that again, huh? Okay. So we'll go ahead and take just a regular ceiling. And now if I go over here, we can place it on top. Now, this is going to be a little weird because, and this is something that I actually found out, if you guys have been watching the Game and Evolve stuff, you'll know Monkey made that really cool-looking, like, glass floating metal base. And we actually, when he was building that, I was over there hanging out one night and noticed this weird thing happen, but I didn't quite understand what happened until after he was done building. So when you go to place this, you see there's a couple snap points, and it's freaking out, right? Well, one of them is taller up, okay? And one of them is actually upside down, too. So it took a little bit of, to be honest, just luck to get it in place. And see, that's the upside down one, right? So now you can see the upside down piece, which is a little crazy. So this, unfortunately, this is just a very finicky part. This is one of the reasons I didn't record. I didn't like the recording for you guys, is that some of this stuff is actually way glitchier than regular arc building, because we are definitely kind of using the system in a way it's not meant to be used. so that's... I mean, that's the basics for it. Oh, see, now it's upside down still. There we go. That's what we want it to look like. Now, I did... You can see that this is still sticking up. On the other build, it doesn't stick up quite as much, so it's definitely a little better for that piece. Now let's see if we can get that other piece in. Oh, and it actually looks like I need one of the other slopes again, so we'll go ahead and jump on here. And which one do we have down here? We have left, so we should need a right. So let's go ahead and try that and see if we can fill in that gap now. Oh, and it does not want to stick in there. So part of this, and the other part of this build, is that I actually placed those in before I did the rest of it, which is why it was a little easier for this to pull off. But that's going to give us the basic shape, though. So let me go ahead and get out here, and I'll show you what we're looking at. I wanted to have the back of the ship actually come up a bit out of the water. So that was kind of what I wanted to do to get that shape set up that way. Now, the only other thing that's a little weird is I also wanted that in the front, okay? So on the front of this right now is that triangle piece we put in. So I'm going to actually take you over to the other ship to show you what I did to get this to work, because I wanted it to be angled, but we couldn't do it with this foundation here. So let me go ahead and we'll jump on this real quick, and we'll kind of head that direction, and I will bring you guys back once we are at the other ship. Alright guys, I'm going to show you this from the bottom first, because I want you to be able to see the whole thing once we actually get inside. So just bear with me for a second while I show you. This is the part I was talking about. So you can see we've got our slope pieces here. And then on the inside, it's all filled in. So I managed to fill everything in for this one, so it didn't have that kind of weird overlapping gap that's on the bottom. And then we kind of have the piece here. So I'm going to go ahead and just take you inside, and we'll kind of go over some of how everything was set up for it. You can see some cannons. So I don't know that this is not... I don't know if this is going to destroy things or not, but these cannons are just set up on pillars and catwalks. And then with their door frames instead of the windows here. I'm hoping that means that it's not going to get destroyed when we shoot the cannons. If it does, we'll have to figure it out. So you can see our beaver back there behind me. And this is kind of the workshop area of this ship now, okay? So you can see back here, this is some of the stuff that actually comes from this mod. So this is a paint bucket. In here, you can actually just make all the paint. It automatically has water. You just put in your berries and charcoal and that kind of stuff, and it's like blueprints for the paint, and you'll be able to make the paint out of it. Pretty cool. This is from the bulk crafting mod. This is like a bulk mortar and pestle. It's almost chemistry bench style. And you can see in here that you have like the five times. And you'll also see we've got some propellant and stuff. We decided that we wanted to be able to build with Adobe, so we found another small mod to put on here that gave us the access to all of that stuff. Then we've got our bulk forge, which works a lot like the industrial forge. Our fabricator is back here. Our 2S plus stuff, crafting station, the smithy. And then we have got the advanced rafts. This is their crafting station. You can see it is just full of crazy cool things. So I used a lot of this stuff upstairs, and I'll show you guys that in just a second. So that's the basics down here. This is open up there. I haven't decided if I'm going to close this off and use this as another room, or if I'm just going to make that access down to here and maybe store some dinos down here. I think I need maple on screen with you guys, right? Didn't I? So that's maple, just in case. We've got some standing torches or some auto wall torches kind of just placed all over the place here, because I wanted to have it nice and lit up at night. But all right, let's go upstairs. So we've got, on both sides, we have a little hatch frame, and we've got some ladders. I don't know if you guys can hear, we've got some water going. So there's something important for us to have on the high seas. This is my cabin, okay? So this is so this we have some citronel here, so we can make sure that we don't get scurvy, because you have to worry about scurvy when you're on the high seas. As a pirate, scurvy is the worst. So we're going to make sure we don't get scurvy. We have citronel up here. So to do that, we use some of the S plus stuff again, where you can see the water symbol on the floor. That means that we've actually irrigated that, and there's a pipe actually hidden down there that's tied into this. And the S plus pipes can go on rafts, so it works really nice. And then over here, we've got just, you know, a little dining area in case, you know, Fox and I or somebody else's UTC maybe is hanging out with us. We'll have a place to be able to sit down. Go ahead and have ourselves... Oh, let's get out of K camera. Okay, or... this is weird. So we have a nice little place if we decide to have a sit down and maybe eat with them. We've got a place we can do that. I don't remember this being in this weird angle, but hey, all right, that's cool. So we've got that going, which is a nice little place to eat. We just got some storage stuff around here, you know, some chests and stuff, the bed to get back to it. And then over here we have our writing area. There's our ship log, and this is a really cool thing too on this mod. That little thing in front of us, that little metal tin. That's a refrigerator, guys. It's crazy. Look at this thing. 50 slots, no power needed. Bam. It's just there, ready to go. So that's the basics on the cabin here. Hope you guys dig that. Let's go ahead and shoot outside. So you've got some decorations here. Nothing too crazy. A little decoration here. But let's go ahead and get up here. I put the gardener here. Okay, so I'm going to have to kind of step out here a little bit so you guys can see. You can kind of see the green sails, obviously, but let's go ahead and take a look at what we have on the outside of this. So this is what the ship looks like. I wanted to kind of have, I don't know, a pirate ship kind of, but I wanted to kind of have some different levels to it, and I thought this was kind of a cool layout to do for that. So we've got some different levels to kind of get up. It's not a huge ship. It's really just made for me. It's going to be my little mobile base. It's bigger than the nest, obviously. I wanted something that's a little bit closer to an actual pirate-style ship. This is their, like, grill, industrial grill here. A bigger version of the fridge, and this is actually a water reservoir that you can see. We can put stuff in to fill it up if we needed to, but... and then these sails are, okay, and look, let's be honest here. Let me tell you what's going on. The reason that we used advanced rafts is because I wanted these sails. I'm going to go underwater a little bit so you can see. Those things are huge, and that's not the largest ones. Those, like, the one behind it is the large one, and this is actually a smaller one up front, so we can kind of get the look for that. But, so these things do two cool things. Other than looking awesome and being paintable, which is sweet, they actually... Okay, a little bit of lag there. They actually provide warmth as well. Oh, while we're down here. You can see right there the tip of that pipe. So that's what's irrigating the whole ship for us. I buried it inside a foundation to kind of try to keep it protected. So let's go ahead and go back up top, upstairs, up the rope ladder, you know, to the deck. We'll go back up here. So in these guys right here, if you place spark powder... You can actually light the fire. And at the very top, we now have fire, and it actually changes the temperature of this area. So the insulation goes up from being near this thing, which is sweet. If we take it up someplace cold, we are good to go. So we can just... Oh, did I put... There it goes. A little bit of lag again. Okay, so now we got that stuff going too. Now, unfortunately, you still can't drive from up top, and since I gotta drive from the bottom, this is the S plus gardener. I think it's supposed to hold on to... Oh, yeah, okay. So there we go. He's definitely holding on to stuff. You're supposed to have to put beer in him. We didn't do that, so good job, gardener guy. You're the helmsman. Good work. So let me go ahead and go down in here. We'll get you guys an idea of what this actually looks like when this beast is moving. So you can kind of see what we're working with here. All right, check this out. Oh, actually, before we do this, one more thing. So... advanced rafts, if you long press E, you'll see we've got default, which is the third person view is the regular one, right? There's a times 3, a times 6, and a times 9. We're going to do times 6, okay? And that's what this looks like at times 6. You can actually see the whole ship now. How cool is that? I hope you guys like it. I really wanted to have kind of a cool design. I thought this definitely worked out better than the traditional ship that I had before. Oh my gosh, I almost forgot the thing I was telling you about that's important and you can't really do the other way. So, let's go back outside just so you can see this real quick. Oh, and you can kind of see this in action now. Got our loading dock. We can just dive right out here. So I'm going to swim close to this in a second so you can see how I did this. It's a little weird, but it's the only way I could get this to snap right. So you see how we've got the front edge is picked up a little bit. Let's go over so there's a little more light. See that? How it's picked up a little bit there? So to do that, it has to snap to a wall, okay? And I didn't have a wall. So this was a triangle foundation, and now the piece in front of us is a sloped wall, the triangle sloped roof, another sloped wall, and then down here, there's actually a triangle ceiling. But if you look right here, you can kind of see it's a little filmy. That's because this is actually a glass wall. I just turned it off so you couldn't see any of the outside pieces. But that was the only way for me to get that piece to snap up there that way like I wanted to get that the slightly clipped up piece on the very front. So yeah, there you guys go. That's the new boat. I don't have a name for it yet. If you guys they have some cool, crazy name, you let me know. Because I don't know yet. But let's go ahead and get in there. Let's jump in the boat. Let's take her out for a spin and see what she's made of, eh? This is what I'm talking about. We're traveling in style now. Look at this guy. Oh, yeah. I feel like we should be singing some pirate shanties, or there should be fog rolling in, and we should have a certain captain at the top of the mast there. This is my boat, though. It's not his. It's my boat. This is Captain Arahli's boat. Oh, this is great, guys. So this is that six times third person view. That's right. This is kind of how you sit when you're out here like this. This is a bigger boat, which means that you can actually like it's you know decently framed. But let's go ahead and switch to the 9x so you can see how silly this is. Look at that. So it's crazy because you could actually have a gigantic ship with that and still be able to see no problem. Because look how small this looks now. In comparison, now that we've got it out in this crazy long view, you know? So, let's go ahead and get these guys real quick. And we probably need to get out a K-camera so I can see where I'm going. There we go. It's so far out that, the K-camera seems weird to have it out like that. The only thing I wish is that we went a little faster. Because I would like to go a little faster than this. This is, you know, raft speed, which is great. But I do want a little faster. All right, so let me know what you guys think. I hope you like this layout, this raft, this ship. I think it's kind of cool. I just wanted a different design and something a little different than we've had before. Let's go ahead and test this out real quick because I haven't done this yet. So if we're going to break something, now is probably the time to do it. So let me go ahead and zoom, 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 zoom back in. Whoop, whoop. So I'm gonna try it out. You guys ready? Oh, I'm gonna break my ship. That a lot of grinding went into getting this stuff ready so I can show you guys this. Oh god. Alright, moment of truth. Please don't break my ship. Oh, it did not break the ship, guys. It didn't break it. Did it do any damage? Can I see? Do nothing. So door frames are golden. Oh, awesome. All right, let's actually go out here, too. Let's make sure I show you guys this. What do we got here? We got a couple more levels. Let's go ahead and pump some health again, get some weight on her. Oh, you're happy about that, huh? So let me show you guys the loading dock, actually, in action, too, okay? So we come back here, open her up, and go right on out. No problem. We'll get on up over towards shore so you can kind of see what we're looking at from this perspective. That's it. That's our ship. That's our baby. And then, to get back in, all we gotta do... And now, this is a little hard. What the... Okay. This is a little hard, because this beaver is fast. So I have to make sure I'm not sprinting. But I just have to kind of get a little... Right there. In we go. Done. So, it's not gonna hold a ton of ships. The ship's not gonna hold a ton of dinos, but it's gonna hold kind of the important ones for us. We're gonna get, you know, a bird or two, and we'll probably park them up top in the little roosty area. Yeah. Welcome back, guys. Check it out what the fire's going. Now, I wanted to show you something that I actually learned from one of the patrons on this server. Giddy Goblin showed something off in one of his videos that I didn't even know existed. So if you guys have been watching any of the other stuff, you'll know that like on the swamp build, one of the things Fox did is we colored we colored these torches different for the fire. And we did that by putting angler gel in it, right? So if you put angler gel in these, that okay, or not. They'll turn blue is kind of the goal. That's what they do. They turn blue. But Giddy told me, and well, he showed in the video too, that with rare mushrooms and rare flowers, you can get different colors. So we've got red that we can do with the rare mushrooms, which is crazy looking. And then what he ended up doing that I thought was really cool looking, oops, let me stay on there, is that he put in the rare flowers, and that gives you this really eerie green color. Look at that, man. That green flame is awesome. So I don't know if we're going to switch the colors at all or not. I do like the green. It's a really an eerie look for it. But I think for now we're just going to leave the regular stuff in. And I don't know why. The angler gel doesn't seem to work. The angler gel was making everything blue before, but it's not doing it. No. So I don't know. That's it. That's what we're doing, guys, right here. This is our new ship. Our new pirate base. Our headquarters. You scurvy curs. Yeah, let me know what you guys think. If you like it, that's cool. If you don't, please give me some constructive criticism, I guess. Alright, if you guys enjoyed the video, please feel free to drop a like below. You can always subscribe for more content, and I will catch you on the flip side.